Hello there, and welcome to the 3CH guide on using and calibrating a pH meter. Okay, now they do come factory calibrated, but because of prolonged storage, it's a good idea to recalibrate when you unbox the product. Okay, in the box itself, you have a calibration solution and the meter itself. You'll notice that the meter doesn't have the batteries in, and actually switching the batteries down for the first time will switch your meter on. Okay, taking the mask off, making sure that it's fully clean, and give it a shake like you would do with any mercury probe or thermometer. And as you can see, you've got a flashing light waiting to be calibrated. So from there, we're going to take the calibration fluid. Now the calibration fluid's open, we're going to put the probe into it like so, making sure it's fully submerged into the fluids, and then you press and hold the calibrate button until you get it flashing, which it is now. See the cal? Now you're waiting for it to reach the end of its calibration check, and then the flashing light will go static, and that will indicate that it's calibrated to 7. There you go, that's now calibrated at 7. Okay. Now again, when you're using the pH meter, it is a good idea to give it a good flick to make sure that all the access is off. And there you go, you have your meter calibrated at 7. Now I've got here a jug of water, and I'm just going to place it in and give you a reading on what the water is. And as you can see, I've just pressed that button, so you've got a flashing light there that's checking the pH of the water from the tap. Peaked and it's now static, and that's reading 7.5. Okay, as you saw, we've got a 7.5 reading of standard tap water, and how you would adjust your pH now is with using pH down, sorry about the state of the bottle, it's all on the shop props, and a pipette. Now please take care when using any sort of adjustment for your pH, as they are acids and they're very caustic and dangerous. So please make sure that you use the utmost safety precautions when adjusting pH and handling the bottles, etc. Because it's only a small amount of water, I'm literally just going to add one drip or two drips of pH down. Give it a nice mix so it has a chance to evenly be distributed through the water. And now we're going to retest. And you do that again by suspending the probe in the water and pressing test. We now have a flashing LED again, and we're waiting for it to find its exact measurement, at which point it will stop flashing and give you an accurate reading. There we go, and as you can see there, that's now reading 6.2, which is quite a drop, considering it was only two drips in the best part of a litre of water. And that again goes to a saying about the strength of the acids you're using, and to be very careful with them. But that's about it, that's all you have to do. Bring it down to the relevant pH that you require for your plants, and that's it. On a personal note, make sure you keep these calibrated every 30 days, as a good rule of thumb, to make sure they don't go off too far off track. And again, when you finish using it, give it a flick off to make sure it's fully dry, and always store with the cap on, so you're not going to get any contaminants on your probe. And to switch off, hold the button in until you lose the LED display, and that's the unit switched off. Thanks for watching.